cup, and you're going to use this cup again, you know how awful it is to have to clean it?
And you just dump it in there.
Oh, so that's a trick.
I like
that. All be up, and then I can put it in the mixer, and then that makes this. So this is where we are. And this needs to be refrigerated. And what I did is I used my pastry chef there, and I'll just take the flour and scoop it on, you know, and make it. That will get a little bit. I'm just going to mix them off like that. And you want to keep it covered because it'll dry out. Kind of like Play-Doh. You're going to rub flour all over the back of your cookie sheet. You're not going to cook in the cookie sheet, you cook on the back of the cookie sheet. The reason being, if you were to take it from here to put it in the inside the cookie sheet, it distorts. You know, it can't. Roll it out. You want it about a quarter of an inch, kind of thin, not too thin. About right there. We'll do this in. There's actually three pieces to this gingerbread house. So you're just going to peel this off. Five to 5 1/2 cups of flour, a teaspoon of baking soda, a teaspoon of salt, 2 teaspoons of ginger, 2 teaspoons of cinnamon, 1 teaspoon nutmeg, 1 teaspoon of cloves, 1 cup of shortening, 1 cup of sugar, 1 1/4 cups of molasses, and 2 eggs that are beaten. And what you'll do is you'll use flour, soda, salt, ginger, all those dry ingredients you'll mix in a bowl and just set aside. And then the shortening, sugar, molasses, and eggs go on the stove and you kind of, you know, cook the egg down so you don't have problems with that. Sometimes, especially on the big one, I can only get one piece at a time. And it's going to cook for about 12 minutes. This is what goes in my oven. And you just kind of keep looking at it. You can tell if it's not done. What I do after they come out of the oven and they're all done, I'll put this back on and take a knife and trim off all the excess. And then that's ready. And you want to let them cool really good. Be hard like this.
Like a cookie. Okay.
You know, this is a gingerbread house. Start of a gingerbread house. Do all your stuff while it's flat. So after you put it together, you're kind of working on, you know, the sidewall there. But when you do put it all together, you can seam the inside. You don't necessarily seam the outside. It's a royalizing, and it's basically it's your cement. It's a hard icing. Take that. I use the cup simply because I need something to hold it down, you know. And you want to keep this covered too, because this will dry out real fast. Take your cup away. So what you do is you stick your tip inside the bag, cut the end of the bag off so that you can get your tip in there. And just squeeze it down. One of the other things I've done before is I've made windows. You can't do that afterward, and it doesn't have to be perfect because you're going to cover all the little seams up. Now, I should have thinned my icing. It's been setting overnight, so what you can do is take just a little bit of water and mix it in. Put it in like that, and I'm going to put a lot more on this one because it's going to join this one. I did this one year and had some girls over, and we just had a cake decorating party. Okay, then when that's dry, you can go up the sides and everything. Egg whites in a can, and that's what they use for making all your icings. You don't want to use regular egg whites because you're not going to cook it. The icing consists of 3 tablespoons of the meringue powder, 4 cups of sifted powdered sugar, about a pound, and 6 tablespoons of water. And you beat that for 10 minutes, and pretty soon you've got this nice fluffy icing. That way, better take that out. It's gonna go on like that, something like that. I love that song.
I do too.
So this, and you're going to let him set up pretty good, and then you're gonna ice all of these. This one's very crude, I'm sorry. its back wall is coming down, it's not going to pass code.
We won't call it.
So, now on the windows like this too, the little cake topping, Christmas tree and that stuff, you could have glued that in the back, you know, so that when you look through the window you saw the Christmas tree. You can buy rounds from Michael's, but I get a cardboard box and I just cut circles out, put foil on it, stick it on that, and then you'll secure it to the, you know, to the doily. So this is marshmallow twist that you can get. They're individually wrapped, and I just cut them to fit, and then I secured the whorehound in the corner, so it looks like it's the gingerbread and stuff, some columns on it, Legos. Edible eight Legos. And they stick together just like kids' Legos do. And we have gumdrops and these little guys. They come in a package, so pop them off. That's where the wreaths came from also. Is a peep.
A peep?
A peep. It's a Christmas peep. You know, they had little ducks for Easter. So it's a snowman. It's a peep. Peppermint has an oil in it. And you can't have oil touching this, it disintegrates. These are candied rocks. When my daughter comes from California, I buy them in bulk. And I can buy 2 pounds for $2. Oh, these little guys are wrapped candy peanut butters. Mm-hmm. It's just cotton candy stuck in there. But I'm going to pass this around so you can taste the candied rocks. I'm thinking next year, I think I'd like to do the courthouse, the square.
Ooh, up the roof. They're jawbreakers.
Itsy bitsy jawbreakers. You can get those in packages. And then I just took a pound of sugar and dusted it. Just take your pound of sugar. I cut little arcs and I cut them in half and secured them. So I learned to dust the cardboard. That's something you need to do, and then you dust these just like you would regular. Put on a board, the heavy board because it could be substantial, and then wrapped in foil, and then I iced the whole top of it.
Before you put the house on it?
No, afterwards. That was the last thing I did. Fence to go around.
Oh, I love it.
If you want to make Christmas trees, get Christmas ice cream cones and ice them. Make Christmas trees. Do that.
You could do just the cones and the trees
right.
For a kids' project, couldn't you?
Now, I was talking about. I think that's it. It is easy, and you just.